How's it going, everyone? Jay here with LMR.com. In today's video, we'll be going over the detailed instructions covering the steps on how to change the supercharger oil in the belt for select factory Ford Mustang and Lightning supercharged vehicles. In 1999, Ford released the well-known SVT Lightning truck, which stunned the performance world with a factory supercharged 5.4-liter engine. They then followed this up with the 0304 Cobra and the 07-14 GT500. These supercharged vehicles are known for how much heat they produce. Over time, this heat causes breakdown of the internal oil and can cause premature wear on the belt drive. Essential maintenance of the oil and the belt are integral to keeping your high-performance machine in check. Today in the shop, we have my 2012 GT500 with almost 195,000 miles on it. I purchased this car with 182,000 miles on it, and there was no telling when this car was last maintained. This makes it a perfect candidate for supercharger maintenance. If you want to see what type of power it made on the dyno when I got it, click on the link in the description below. I think you will be pretty surprised. These basic steps shown within this video can cross over to the earlier 0304 Cobra and the 99-04 Ford Lightning trucks. Regardless of the application, we have you covered. Check out the link in the description below for belt routing and sizing guides for all of these applications. Some of the tools you will need for this service will be a 3/8 and 1/4 inch socket set, an Allen key set, assorted wrenches, a syringe with a 1-foot section of tubing, and a 3/8 inch breaker bar or ratchet. Start by locating the supercharger drain fill plug on the snout of the blower. Set a clean rag under the plug to catch any fluid that may come out. In our application, a 3/16 Allen socket was used to remove this one. Once you have this out, go and inspect the O-ring and replace this if need be. Insert your hose from the syringe into the hole and push it until it bottoms out. Pull back on the plunger and remove your fluid. As you can see here, our fluid was very dark and had years of wear and needed to be changed. Continue this process until you have removed as much fluid as you can. Using some brake clean, thoroughly clean all of the old fluid from the syringe at this time. Once the syringe is clean, you can fill the supercharger up with clean fluid. Check your owner's manual for your specific fluid capacity. Continue to fill through this hole until the fluid starts to dribble out. Once you are at this point, reinstall the plug and clean up any excess fluids. Now we can move to the belt drive. Again, this will vary depending on the model you are working with. To make more room, we chose to remove the factory coolant tank and airbox. The coolant tank will be held in place by 2 10mm bolts. The airbox will vary depending on the application. Usually you will have a few clamps, electrical connections, and bolts that will hold this one in place. On this GT500, the supercharger belt is located behind the Serpentine belt drive. Loosen and remove the 10mm nut holding the hose bracket in place to give you better access to the belt tensioner. Now you can locate the Serpentine belt tensioner and using a 15mm wrench, release the tension. Now you can fully remove the belt. Once this is out of the way, we can locate the supercharger belt tensioner. Release the tension using a 3/8 ratchet with a 1-inch extension and remove the belt from any pulley in this area. To remove the supercharger belt, we did have to unbolt the 15mm bolt on the tensioner from the front end. Once this is off, you will be able to remove the belt off of the vehicle. Route the new belt on the lower crank and the AC compressor. Then reinstall the belt tensioner using the 15mm socket. Then reroute the new belt in its proper orientation. Depending on your vehicle, these applications can vary. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, check out the link in the description below to see how your belt will need to be routed. Go ahead and reinstall the Serpentine belt. Now you can go back on with the lower hose bracket and the 10 millimeter nut. Now you can go back on with the air box and the coolant tank at this time. Check over your work and you are all done. All right, everyone, we hope this video has helped you have a better understanding of how to service your supercharger oil and belts for your factory supercharged vehicles. As you can tell, my GT500 really needed this maintenance with the number of miles it has on it. Overall, this one should roughly take you about an hour to an hour and a half to complete. If you like this video, make sure to give us a thumbs up. Subscribe to our channel if you've not already, and turn on notifications to keep you up to date with any new tech info we release. As always, make sure to keep it here with the real Mustang enthusiasts at LMR.com.